You're probably already familiar with the Select tool and the Direct Select tool in Illustrator, but there's a third main selection tool that's super handy for selecting shapes inside of groups and groups inside of groups. Today we're going over the Group Selection tool. You can find the Group Select tool in your toolbar under the Direct Select menu, or if you're already using the Direct Select tool, you can toggle to the Group Selection tool by hitting Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC. To demonstrate the Group Selection tool, I'm going to use this illustration that's neatly organized into nested groups. This illustration is built on one main layer, with three groups representing the foreground, the city, and the sky, and then nested groups inside each to organize different elements. If I were to try to select one of the trees with the selection tool, I would actually select the entire group. If I go grab my group selection tool and click on this tree, I'll just get the single shape. The first time you click with the group selection tool, it behaves almost like the direct select tool in that it's just selected this single path. If I click a second time, I'll have the entire group of trees selected. If I click a third time, I'll have the entire park group selected. So the group tool actually moves up the hierarchy. Your first click will be a single path, your second click will be the group that contains that path, and the next click will be the group that contains that group. This tool is really handy for making quick edits to illustrations like this that are a little bit more complex. Say I wanted to select just the leaves on the trees. Since that's a whole group, I can select that with two clicks of the group selection tool, and then I'd be free to go ahead and change the color of the trees all at once. Having a good understanding of the selection tools is extremely important for your workflow in Illustrator. If you're not already sure about the differences between the Select tool and the Direct Select tool, you can learn about that here. And if you're looking for shortcuts to deselect your artwork, you can learn about that here. I hope that was helpful. Please feel free to leave me any questions you have in the comments below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.